So good morning, my name is Leonardo Bautista. First of all, I want to thank you and the Foundation for inviting me to this event. So this is my first talk in the blockchain community or the Ethereum community. So allow me to first introduce myself. So I'm originally from Nicaragua, which is that little country in the middle of Central America. I grew up in Nicaragua in Colombia, and then I moved to Paris, where I did my studies in distributed computing, in my bachelor and my master in the Paris 6 University, getting my degree. Then I moved to Tokyo, where I did my PhD on fault tolerance for high performance computing, Tokyo Institute of Technology. At the end of my PhD, I was offered a position as a postdoc researcher in Argonne National Lab, near to Chicago, where the first nuclear reactor was invented. And 2 years ago, I was offered a senior researcher position at the Barcelona Supercomputing Center, which is where I am working right now. To give you an introduction of the Barcelona Supercomputing Center, it has over 500 employees, 80% of those are researchers. We do research in computer science, high performance computing applications, air science, biology, climate, and so on. So this is also the host of one of the biggest supercomputers in Europe. It's Mare Nostrum 4, okay, which is located in Barcelona. And it has a performance of about 11 petaflops. Okay. It's actually the top 22nd fastest supercomputer in the world. I think it's in the top 5 of the fastest supercomputers in Europe. This is a picture of it. It's located just next to our offices. It has 3,456 nodes. Each one of those nodes has two processors, Xeon Platinum, each one with 12 cores. So that allows you to make executions on over 160,000 processes at the same time. In this supercomputer, we do simulations about climate, weather simulations, computational fluid dynamics, molecular dynamics, artificial intelligence, and so on. And so, my idea for this project was to try to do to simulate a charted blockchain in a supercomputer. And basically, write two of the parameters that we are still discussing about how is the best way to implement sharding. What this allows you to do is also to play with different aspects that are not that easy to play in a testnet, for example. You can try to play with the availability of the nodes and increase or decrease the availability. You can try to accelerate time a little bit because you are doing a simulation. You can try to play with different number of notary, different number of charts, what is the best look-ahead period in order for the clients to update in time, and so on and so on and so on. So this is the idea of this project, is to simulate a chart blockchain in the supercomputer. So I was doing a first implementation on my own with message passing internet interface. Sorry. We call it MPI. It's a library to communicate between different processes in a supercomputer. But at the same time, Vitalik released a proof of concept about charting. So I took this code and I started trying to study, understand it. I documented it and I refactored it because this code is running sequential in one single node. And the idea would be to have this running on a distributed scenario, many cores at the same time. So this is what I'm doing. The good thing is that it's already implemented some of the things that we have been discussing, like a different chain and so on and so on. Okay. The idea is to run this, to parallelize this, to implement all the features that are not there, because there are quite a number of features that are not. And try to make experiments in a supercomputer. This gives you different types of results. This is just a nice figure that shows you how different charts behave. The blue line is the main chain, the green one is the beacon chain, the yellow ones are the charts, and the red lines are basically the connection between the collations in different charts and the blocks in the beacon chain. And so, but of course, this doesn't give you much information about how the network is behaving, whether these parameters are good or not. And so, this is what I'm implementing right now on this code. So, this is basically it. This is the status of the project. The project is just starting as of now. We have a first version of the code that is online in this link. And if you are interested in contributing or helping or have questions, don't hesitate to contact me. You have my email address and everything.